Good morning, class 9. Welcome back. So you are in chapter number 13, surface areas and volumes. So we have discussed curved surface area, total surface area of all the solid shapes that we have in our syllabus. Cube, cuboid, cylinder, cone and sphere. Now we are moving into volumes of the solids. So I have taken few questions from exercise 13.5 and 13.6. These are the questions which are based on the volumes of solid shapes that we have studied. Okay, the question number 6 of exercise 13.5. A village of 4000 people requires 150 liters of water per head per day. Each person requires 150 liters of water per head per day. It has a tank of capacity 20 meters. Cross 15 meters, cross 6 meters. For how many days will the water of the tank last? So it's very simple. Volume of water consumed by all 4000 people in one day, this will be divided into the volume of the tank. So we will get number of days the water in the tank that can last. So one more thing. The dimensions of the tank are in meters, whereas the volume of water is given in liters. So we have to convert it, right? Let's see how we convert it. So water consumption, total consumption per day equal to number of persons multiplied by the water that is required for each person, that is 150 liters. So children, 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. So if I multiply it by 1000, it becomes centimeter cube. I have to convert centimeter cube into meter cube. So 100 centimeters is 1 meter. So this is centimeter, which is becoming meter. We need meter cube. So 100 into 100 into 100. Once again, I'm saying 4000 persons, each person requires 150 liters. 1 liter is 1000 centimeter cube. So I have multiplied it by 1000. Now this becomes the total consumption of water per day in centimeter cube. I have to convert it into meter cube because the dimensions of the tank are in meters. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. Okay. 15 into 40. 600 meter cube. This is the requirement of the village per day. Okay, now we'll find the volume of the tank. Volume of tank. So it's in the shape of a cuboid, L into B into H, very simple. Volume 20 into 15 into 6 meter cube. So this is 20 into 90. This becomes 1800 meter cube. This is the total capacity of the tank, total water that is there in the tank. Now, number of days the water lasts. Total capacity of the tank divided by water that is required per day. Zeros cancel with zeros, 18 upon 6 is 3 days. So the water in the tank will survive, will last for 3 days for 400 in a village of 4000 people, where each person requires 150 liters of water per day, right? Okay, another question. A river 3 meters deep and 40 meter wide is flowing at a rate of 2 kilometers per hour. River is flowing means the water in the river is moving at the speed of 2 kilometers per hour. The river is flowing towards the ocean or the sea. How much water? How much water means it's asking about the capacity, volume, amount. How much water will fall into the sea in a minute, in 1 minute? Okay, let's see. Let us understand it in a better manner by a diagram. This is how, to some extent, the shape of the river will be. Now it says 3 meters deep and 40 meters wide. This is the width of the river. It is given as 40 meters. Okay? And its height is 3 meters. Depth of the river means height of this cuboid. It is given as 3 meters. Now water is flowing at the rate of 2 kilometers per hour. So in 60 minutes, it covers a distance of 2 kilometers. 2 kilometers is 2000 meters. Right? Now, in 1 minute, it will be 2000 upon 60. 0 cancel. So, it is 100 upon 3 meters. Okay, children. So this will be the length of the water column. Suppose a water molecule starts from here. In 1 minute, it will reach this distance, that is 100 upon 3 meters. So this entire cuboidal structure, whatever water it contains, this will be the volume of water that will fall into the sea in 1 minute. Okay. So this becomes length. Now, volume of water falling into the sea. It's the shape of a cuboid, L into B into H. 100 upon 3 into B. Width is 40 meters into height, that is depth of the river, is 3 meters. Meter cube will be the unit of volume. 3, cancel with 3, 4000 meter cube. This is the volume of the water that will fall into the sea per minute from this particular river when the water is flowing at the rate of 2 kilometers per hour. So this was the solution. Hope you got it. Let's move ahead. Okay, next exercise 13.6, question number 4. It says the curved surface area or the lateral surface area of a cylinder is given as 94.2 centimeter square and its height is 5 centimeters. We have to find the radius of the base and the volume of the cylinder, right? So here we'll consider pi is equal to 3.14. So given curved surface area is 2 pi r h. This is given as 94.2 centimeter square. So 2 into 3.14 into r. R we don't know, into height. Height is given as 5 centimeters. Is equal to 94.2. Now R is equal to 94.2 divided by 2 into 5, 10 into 3.14. There are two places after the decimal. Here it is one place. Multiply this 10 will be multiplied here. So we have 94.2 divided by 31.4, right, children? Now, one place after the decimal, one place after the decimal. Multiply numerator and denominator by 10. So, this becomes 942 upon 314. Okay. So, on dividing, we get 3. So, R equal to 3 centimeters. We got the radius of the base of the cylinder. Now, we need to find the volume of the cylinder. Volume of the cylinder. Volume is pi r square h. Volume of a right circular cylinder, pi r square h. So pi is 3.14 into r square. R square becomes 9 into h. H is how much? 5. Okay. So 5 multiplied by 3.14. 15.7 multiplied by 9. It is 141.3 centimeter cube. Okay. So this is the volume of the cylinder. Right. Let's move on to another question. A cylindrical wooden pencil, a pencil which is in the shape of a cylinder, has a solid graphite cylinder filled inside. Graphite cylinder. Pencil ke andar wo nook hoti hai na, that is graphite. Okay. So graphite. The diameter of the pencil, the entire pencil has the diameter 7 millimeters. So radius will be 7 upon 2 millimeters. And of graphite, diameter of graphite is 1 millimeter. So radius of the graphite will be 1 upon 2 millimeters. We have to find the volume of wood in the pencil and the volume of graphite separately. Okay. So volume of wood kaise nikalenge? पूरी पेंसिल का वॉल्यूम निकाल लेंगे, ग्रेफाइट का वॉल्यूम निकाल लेंगे. फ्रॉम द वॉल्यूम ऑफ एंटायर पेंसिल सबट्रैक्ट द वॉल्यूम ऑफ ग्रेफाइट. सो वी विल बी लेफ्ट विद द वॉल्यूम ऑफ वुड दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन दैट पेंसिल. ओके, लेट्स सी. Volume of the entire pencil. It is in the shape of a cylinder. So pi r square h, 22 upon 7 into. Diameter of the pencil is 7 millimeters. So radius will be 7 upon 2. R square. So 49 upon 4 into h. Height. Height of the pencil. Height of the pencil I must have missed from the question. Let's check it. Height of the pencil. Okay. Length is given as 14 centimeters. The length of the pencil is 14 centimeters. Okay, length of the pencil means height of the cylinder. Suppose this is the pencil, its length is 14 centimeters, so it will be the height of the cylindrical part. So it is 14. Okay, now 7 goes 7 times, 2 goes 2 times, 2 goes 11 times, 2 goes 7 times. So we are left with 11 into 49, 53 millimeter cube. This is the volume of the entire pencil. Now, volume of graphite. Graphite means jo nook uske andar hai. Pi. Graphite, the diameter of graphite is 1 millimeter, so radius will be 1 by 2. R square 1 by 4 into h. H is 14. 7 goes 1 time, 7 goes 2 times. 2 goes 2 times and 2 goes 11 times. So it is 11 millimeter cube. This is the volume of graphite that is used in the pencil. we need the volume of wood. Volume of wood is equal to volume of entire pencil 539 millimeter cube minus the volume of graphite which is inside, that is 11 millimeter cube. 539 minus 11 is equal to 528 millimeter cube. This will be the volume of the wood that is used in making the pencil. So I hope you understood these four solutions. Based on these, you can solve the remaining questions of exercise 13.5 and 13.6. Okay children, we shall meet in the next class. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, be regular in your studies. Goodbye.